Welcome to Inside Zebulon, a show to introduce you to the Zebulon Chamber of Commerce and our members. I'm your host, Kim Valentine. The mission of our chamber is to promote the general welfare and prosperity of the businesses of Zebulon and Wake County. Supporting local business is important, and we want you to know who's doing business in our area. Hi there, I am here with Sherry Orner, Associate Director of Safe Haven Cat Shelter and Clinic here in Raleigh. Sherry, thank you for letting us come in and look around today.
Thank you guys so much for coming to visit us here at the shelter. Safe Haven has been around for about, we're in our 19th year.
Wow.
We started back in 1994 in a heated and air conditioned garage of our now executive director and founder. In 2001, we also opened a low-cost spay-neuter clinic here at the shelter, which is in our other building, which is just down the street. That clinic operates 5 days a week by appointment only, and it's all low-cost spay-neuter services. We don't turn anyone away, regardless of their ability to pay.
Wow.
The shelter houses, at any point, about 100 cats that are up for adoption between the two buildings.
Okay.
These are the cats in this building that are currently ready for adoption. The cats down at the other building are finishing up their medical care and will be up here as soon as there's space.
Okay. Now, you've placed over 5,000?
We're over 5,300 cats right now.
Wow.
Into loving homes.
In our
19th year. Mm-hmm.
And it started out small. You've added services.
Oh, yes. It started out small, and we've expanded three or four different times now.
Mm-hmm.
We keep expanding as we can. And our goal, of course, is to end overpopulation. And the only way we're going to do that is through adoption, but also, more importantly, through spay-neuter.
Spay-neuter. Mm-hmm. Well, that's wonderful. So how does it work? Do people contact you? They find you on the website?
People find us through the web. Probably the most common way is Google. Also, a lot of word of mouth. People who have adopted from us refer adopters. People with stray cats call us. Because we are a limited access shelter, we're a no-kill shelter.
Mm-hmm.
We do work a wait list at all times. So if people call us, we ask them if they're willing to keep up with the cat until we can take it.
Okay.
And a lot of times to get a cat into a no-kill facility, people are willing to do that
right.
because they don't want to have to take it to a euthanizing shelter.
Well, I saw you have a number of testimonials from people that have had wonderful experiences here adopting cats, and even the volunteers themselves.
Yes, our volunteers are our best adopters.
Mm-hmm.
They love
cats. Yeah, there was a gentleman, one of the videos that I watched, he said he was hoping that being here and getting his cat fixed would eliminate him taking any cats home, but that didn't work out.
No,
so well.
That's actually Ray, one of our,
yeah.
he's a cleaner, he's an adoption counselor, and he and his partner have adopted 3 cats from us.
Wow.
So,
now, how many volunteers do you have that are working here?
At any given time, we have about 150 to 200 active volunteers that kind of come in and come
that
out.
Do shifts?
Yeah, we mm-hmm. don't require a certain amount of volunteer time here. We do ask people to try to fit us in a few times a month, but
mm-hmm.
we have people who come in the summer and only can volunteer during their summer breaks, and we appreciate that. We have shifts every day of the week,
mm-hmm.
so we have something for everybody, working people, students. Our minimum age for volunteering is 16,
okay.
But our most pressing need is always cleaning. As with,
mm-hmm.
with 100 and some cats at any given time, we definitely need a lot of cleaning, but then
mm-hmm.
they get a lot of play time at the end, which is, of course, their favorite part.
Now, obviously, you need volunteers to, you know, make everything happen. You also look for donations from people.
Correct. We're always looking for, of course, financial donations because we are a private organization
mm-hmm.
and we get no government funding. All of our donations are from private individuals. But also, we're always looking for items that we can use here. Paper towels. We go through boatloads of paper towels here cleaning up after all these cats is a huge need. Gloves for cleaning. Pretty much anything and everything that you would think of for cleaning we can use here at the shelter.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, items for the cats, beds, litter boxes,
sure.
towels, all kinds of things like that.
And you also have fundraising events.
We do. We do a lot of, we do small fundraisers out in the community. But our biggest fundraisers are, we do an auction for the cats, which is coming up on September 15th at Raleigh Auction and Estate Sales in Raleigh. It is from 5 to 9 p.m. It's a really fun, casual event. We're looking for items for that event that can be dropped off here. Mostly antique-y stuff and,
okay.
and not so much clothes and things, but furniture, antiques,
mm-hmm.
that sort of thing. And then coming up on October 6th is our first annual Run for Their Lives 5K, which will be starting from our facility down at the other end of the street and going for 5K, and people are going to be raising money for the shelter through that. And our biggest fundraising event of the year is the Tuxedo Cat Ball, which is every April.
Okay.
And that is our fancy event, our sort of
so people black purchase tie event. Tickets to attend.
Correct. And it's heavy hors d'oeuvres, silent auction, live auction. It's a lot of fun.
Okay, wonderful. Well, I think it might be time for us to meet some of the
It's always time to meet cats.
Residents of the facility. So let's go meet some. Okay, we're back here. This is Rosaline, one of our little squirmish little kittens that they're hoping to find a home for, correct?
Correct. We are we are looking for a home for Rosaline and for all of these guys. And she is one of our youngest right now up here.
She's
at the adoption
cute.
Center. She is about 12 weeks old. She came to us with her mother and her brother from a one of the euthanizing shelters in the area.
And she flies.
And she wants to leave.
She's like, why is this woman holding me? Look at how sweet you are. Oh my goodness.
She's
so
sweet.
So they basically live here until you can find them homes.
Our cats do live in the adoption center.
Whoop,
and so we find them a home. Other than we do have a foster program, and sometimes we'll send cats to foster to either give them a break from the shelter or if they need a little bit more socialization. Sometimes if they're a little small, we can send them until they're a little bit bigger.
Mm-hmm.
But most of the time they reside here, and we have different types of housing for the cats. Some live in colony housing with other cats
mm-hmm.
because they like to live with other cats. And then we have more of the traditional cages where they live independently but get lots of playtime in our playrooms with our volunteers.
Mm-hmm. Well, this is wonderful. I mean, it looks like you have a great setup for them and they're cared for and played with.
Thank you. We try really hard to do the best we can until they find their home.
Mm-hmm.
We all want them all in homes. As they all leave, I tell them all the time, I hope I never see you again.
Yeah.
I love you, but I don't want to ever see you again.
Right.
So,
well,
that's
that must
our goal.
Be hard. I would be attached to every single one of them. I wouldn't be able to let them
leave. I love them
all,
and I remember most of them, but
yeah.
Really,
hey,
this
now.
Is just a little
Cut
hotel for them until they can get their
Cut
family of their own. And nothing makes us happier than getting updates from our adopters and seeing
sure.
them lounging on beds and cuddling up with their families, because that's really what they deserve.
Yeah. Well, that's wonderful. Now, you are going to be doing a special event or project in Zebulon.
Correct. We applied for a grant from PetSmart Charities for a targeted spay-neuter grant for the area of Zebulon. We had talked to animal control and there was a significant need in Zebulon for spay-neuter services. So they have given us a grant to spay and neuter 820 cats over the next 2 years in Zebulon. And that will be for free for the residents of Zebulon. All they need to do is contact our clinic and indicate that they live in the Zebulon area,
okay.
and that will be a free service for them.
And the date of that?
Well, the date that we're going to have a van in Zebulon is October 27th,
mm-hmm.
and that will be at the Walmart in Zebulon. We're also going to have, at the car show that day, we'll be having a table and a rabies clinic that day.
Mm-hmm.
But the as far as scheduling, they can schedule here anytime.
Okay.
They can call our clinic and get scheduled in here anytime.
Well, that's wonderful. And, you know, it's just amazing what you're doing here. And, you know, I thank you and all the volunteers for everything you do.
Thank you so much for coming out and seeing
us. And we're very happy to have you. Well, I'm very happy to have come out. But as much as I want to, I can't be taking any of these home.
Oh, she'd fit in a pocket.
I bet she would. But she wouldn't stay there for long,
that's
for sure.
That's true.
All right. Well, let's let people know how to contact you.
Okay.
Website, phone number?
Yes. Our phone number is 919-872-7233. Again, 919-872-7233. Our website is safehavenforcats.org. And additionally, if they have any questions and they want to email, they can email info@safehavenforcats.org. Someone gets back to everybody pretty quickly here, so we'd love to hear from you.
Okay. Well, wonderful.
Thank you so much.
And thank you for allowing me to meet Rosaline.
Oh, you're very welcome.
And I think she wants to run around right now. She's a little squirmy.
Let's go play. Good girl, Rosaline.
She's so sweet. All right, well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, Barbara Mason, you've been a volunteer here for how long?
8 years.
Oh, 8 years, okay. And what made you start, you know,
I lived up in Maryland, and I volunteered at a shelter up there. And my daughter moved here, and she started volunteering at Safe Haven. Mm-hmm. And then I started volunteering at Safe Haven.
And clearly, if you're here for 8 years, you're enjoying yourself.
Yes.
You're getting something out of it.
Yes.
What's the experience like for you?
Well, I think it's a win-win. I feel good because I'm helping cats, mm-hmm. but then I get to play with cats.
Yeah.
So it's a win-win,
yeah.
And they're all really great cats. It's a great organization. We've adopted out so many animals,
mm-hmm.
and we do so much with helping people that are having difficult times now with food.
Right.
We spay and neuter animals. We're just involved in a lot of really good projects to mm-hmm. help cats.
And what would you say to somebody that maybe, you know, thinking about volunteering? I mean, can you give them any?
We have lots of shifts. They don't work you that hard,
mm-hmm.
So you always have time to play with the cats. And just go online, and there's a form, I believe, online, and you can apply and come on in. We have a handbook.
Okay.
We'll give you all the training you need, but mostly you just need to love cats.
Well, that sounds
That's pretty
much easy.
It.
All right, well, thank you. I'll let you get back to work.
Thank you very much.
Coming to take a look inside and let everybody know what you have here.
Okay, we're glad to have you.
Okay. What do we want to see first?
All right, let's look at the dining room.
Okay, so this is the dining room. This is beautiful.
This is the dining room for our six clients that we have,
mm-hmm.
Or six clients that we have a maximum of having that eat in here. Every mm-hmm. meal, they love this dining room. We make it as formal and as presentable as possible for them. Absolutely.
Right. Well, that's wonderful.
Fred sets the table for us every meal, and he's so meticulous about what he does. It's just wonderful.
He takes pride in his...
And each one have their own chairs.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely. You don't sit in the wrong chair. It makes a difference.
Well, I'm like that at home. If my kids sit in my chair, I'm like,
absolutely.
Out you go.
It makes a difference on what you eat and how you eat it, you know, according to where you're sitting at. So.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah.
Well, it's beautiful. Again, the way it's decorated and the colors, the furniture, everything about it is home, not mm-hmm. not a hospital or clinical in any way.
Okay.
So this is one of the rooms.
This is one of our single rooms, Kim, where you know, we have a really, really nice person, Fred, that's in here that loves this. His telephone is over there, his TV is over here, and he's able to put all of his pictures up on the wall,
mm-hmm.
and he just loves his room.
Now, and it doesn't have a hospital feel, a clinical feel at all.
Absolutely. We try to make it as home-based as possible.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we don't want them to feel institutionalized at all.
Now, although you want it to feel like a home environment, mm-hmm. you have all the precautions and
absolutely.
Safety features.
Absolutely.
Tell us about the cords over there.
We have the pull cords for them at night that we put on their beds, and we make sure that they're able to reach them at night so they can call us at any point.
Okay.
That gives them another sense of security for us.
Okay.
We do 2-hour checks anyway every night, but that just gives them a little bit more control
okay.
for themselves, that they can get in touch with us at any point. And that goes over the whole entire house.
Mm-hmm.
We can hear that. If we cannot hear that, need to call 911 for us.
Right. Okay. Well, the rooms are beautiful. I
Thank
mean,
you.
It really, you know, I said
Thank
this
you.
Is nicer than my room in my
Thank
house.
You.
So, I mean,
Thank
it's decorated
you.
Beautifully, the furniture. So, you've
Thank
worked
you.
Real hard to give them this type of environment.
I love to do this. This is all about them. We need them to be comfortable and want to be here. We're here to serve them. We have their telephone is available for them. They can get their same phone number at home that they had, you know, so the telephone company will come and hook that up. We have television and cable for them as well. We have a computer access for them. We want them to feel good. We want them to feel comfortable and feel like they're still living, you know. They're still living, not just waiting around to, you know, I'm old and I can't do anything. No, that's not our philosophy at all. We want them to feel comfortable just as they did at home or better than they felt at home.
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure. Well, let's check out some of the other areas.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
This is our living room. We love to sit in here and socialize in a couple of our wonderful, wonderful residents. Okay, right here. This is Tina. Tina, this is my friend Kim.
Hi.
And this is Pauline. Pauline,
hi, Pauline,
this is Kim. And Fred,
and Fred,
the one with the gorgeous room you just saw.
Right. Okay. So this is their social area.
This
they
is
can
one
watch
this
TV
is one of their social areas.
Yeah.
This is one of their social areas.
And they do some activities in
they
here?
They do activities, they quilting. They do quilting, they do sewing, they do a lot of things in here. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah, great.
Well, let's move on to another room.
Okay. This is our kitchen, for which we do everything in here. We don't have any prepared early meals. We cook everything for them.
Okay.
Three wonderful meals.
Okay.
We just relish over how well we prepare their meals. Nothing institutional or packaged or anything of that nature. They love to sit and smell our aromas and things of that nature.
And you have dinner in the dining room every night.
We have dinner in the dining room, three wonderful meals, and actually our setting is just beautiful. We do different settings for each particular meal.
Nice.
From dinner, lunch, breakfast, and whatever. It's a whole different setting. So meals are very, very social.
Yeah.
Very social in here.
And it's an important part of their day. It adds to the experience because you want them to have a good, you know, tasteful and healthy meals.
Absolutely, absolutely. That, you know, that way we're able to keep the weight where it should be, nutritionally acceptable by the physician and everybody else. It's just wonderful. We just have a wonderful time around the table.
Okay.
It's joyous.
Wonderful. All right. Well, so tell us about this room.
Well, this was actually a garage when we first started this whole process, and we didn't use it very much, so we thought about, you know, having something else where the clients can come and have a really good time. And so we looked at this, called our engineers, and turned this into another activities room.
Okay.
So they exercise down here. They we dance down here. We get in a dance group to come in.
Nice.
To dance with us. And so, you know, families come down here. This is just an all-around relaxing environment where they can just, you know, get away from the others or whatever they want to do, that, you know. So they'll come down here and sometimes listen to music or paint or read or something of that nature.
Yeah, I wanted to ask you about these paintings up here.
Well, actually, one of our residents painted this. She's an artist, and she wanted us to put it up on the walls, and she did a wonderful job.
Yes, they're beautiful.
Took a lot of time to do that. And matter of fact, the whole room is part of their decision. They chose the color. They chose the decor up on the windows. And so, you know, we did this as a group project.
As a group.
As a group project. And so they love this room.
Hattie, let's talk a little bit about your background and how you came up with the idea to start this this facility.
Well, I've been a nurse for 34 years. I, of course, academically, I have, you know, three masters, and I've been in all facets, a lot of facets of nursing. And the whole elder process did not bother me when I was in the hospital because it was just a process we went through. They're sick, we heal them, and they're discharged until my own mother became elderly, where we had to actually consider placement for her. We didn't know anything else but a nursing home.
Right.
You know, we didn't know something like this exists back in the 90s. And so we had to place my mom, and it was a wonderful nursing home, whatever that means, and it was just not enough for her. And after she passed in 2000, at 92, we had to place my mother-in-law only 3 years later in a nursing home as well.
Now, and that's where the name of the home
Gracie Sturdivant. Gracie Sturdivant is my mom and Anthony's mom. Gracie is Anthony's mother. And I had the best mother-in-law. I want the world to know that. I had the best mother-in-law in the world. Gracie is his mom, and Sturdivant's my mom.
Okay.
And so we're giving back to those two women.
That's wonderful.
Oh, we love that. Mm-hmm. We love doing what we're we love this stuff. We yeah. really do.
I think that shows in all the care you take and all the little details.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. I party here with them. Mm-hmm. We just love doing this. Yeah. We really, really do. We're honored to be able to take care of them. We're honored to serve them. Mm-hmm. We really are.
So your background and the positions that you've had have really helped you to be able to run a facility like
this. Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. I bring all of my nursing or a lot of my experience from the hospitals or whatever in here mm-hmm. to keep them healthy, keep them vibrant, keep them happy, illness free, all of that. And I have mm-hmm. a wonderful, wonderful healthcare entourage around me. Mm-hmm. I have a board certified physician. I have a wonderful optometrist. I've had dentistry. We have physical therapy.
And they're all local doctors.
They're all local mm-hmm. doctors, absolutely. And it's a wonderful group. And mm-hmm. we all get together to keep these folks healthy.
That's
and it's just,
great.
It works. It just works. Mm-hmm. It really does.
I know you're very particular about the people that you have involved with the residents, including your own staff. You have pretty tough standards.
Well, my expectations are high because mm-hmm. of the folks that I'm taking care of. I mean, it's about the residents. It's not so much about, you know, the employees and about the owners and all of that. It's about the resident. Mm-hmm. And so therefore, I bring people in here who are up for the challenge. Right. We just don't get anybody out of the street. No mm-hmm. way, no how. They have to have experience. They have to go through my orientation. And we have to work together.
Probably like no other.
Well, mm-hmm. well, you know, I mean, it's rewarding. If you do it well, it's yeah. rewarding. If you don't, well, we don't last very long.
Mm-hmm. Now, you know, the people that live here, they can be up and move around, and you take them out. You go out on trips.
Oh, absolutely. We know every restaurant around here. We know absolutely every we love to eat, okay, mm-hmm. as you can see. But we love to eat. And like I said, eating is so social. Mm-hmm. So what we do is we'll go to different restaurants, and we'll pick up their menus a week in advance. And so the whole group have to decide where they want to go.
Okay.
And they're looking at the menu as to what they want to eat, including dessert and everything of that nature. So we know the restaurant by the time we get there,
right.
you know. So we have hit everything. Now we're hitting Raleigh now because I think we've just exhausted
Knightdale.
Absolutely, mm-hmm. absolutely. So we try to do that in a biweekly mm-hmm. system to get them out of the house, to keep them in the community.
And the ladies will go out to have their hair done.
Oh my goodness, absolutely. Mm-hmm. That is so important in here.
That's right.
That's a big
That's
deal.
That's important everywhere.
That's a big deal. Absolutely. We take them to the hairdressers and things of that nature. We also make sure that they have the jewelry that they need because we're still ladies, even though mm-hmm. we're 90 years old.
Right.
We're still ladies. I mean, one of my residents just got permanent eyebrows, mm-hmm. okay, to go with the permanent liner she has. Oh, we don't play in here.
Well, that's
we
wonderful.
Don't play in here. I keep them feeling good about themselves. Mm-hmm. That is just so important. It really, really is. It's very, very important. So we keep their lives going. Mm-hmm. You know, we don't take things away from them just because they've aged.
Right.
They're still human.
It's not a punishment. Yeah.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Mm-hmm.
Now you have a porch out back and you have an outdoor area.
We have.
How is that used?
Oh my goodness, the porch is. They love to sit on the porch, especially either in the morning and have their coffee, or either in the afternoon where they can hear the kids from the schools up there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, especially during what's not called recess anymore, but when they get out
they're
for the
outside,
day. Oh
yeah.
My goodness, that's such a wonderful sound, mm-hmm. and they love that. Plus, they'll listen to the kids in the swimming pool next door. So they love that. And then we'll go out and have picnics down in the yard.
Mm-hmm.
And they love to do that. It's hard to get them back in.
Yeah.
Because
and
sitting under the trees.
Don't they have gardens? They have gardening.
They have the raised gardens. And we had so much vegetable over the summer. We had to keep filtering it out. Because they'll let you know.
Mm-hmm.
When it's time to prune or whatever you're supposed to
yeah.
do, they'll let you know. You know. And so we're having to keep up with them, actually.
That's wonderful.
You know? Yeah.
Now, how did the community, how are you fitting in here?
Oh, my goodness. They are so accepting mm-hmm. of us. So accepting. That's why we're so glad that we have the community providers as well.
Mm-hmm.
They know that we're here. The fire department loves us in a good way.
Right.
In a very, very good way. police department loves us. They'll sit with the residents when they come in here. Because just to give you a funny story, the police banged at the door one day and we're just saying, oh, what's going on? Who called the police? And we says, nobody. Yeah, somebody called 911. And I looked at one of the residents with the phone. I says, there's your culprit right there.
Oh no.
And they stayed actually almost 30 minutes just sitting and engaging and looking at everybody's pictures in the rooms. Oh my goodness. Aww. It was one of the best visits they said they had all month long. Please call us back. Wow. Not that way, right. But call us back. Right. You know. So the community is very accepting of us. When we go out walking with the residents, folks are waving to us and all of that. Matter of fact, our optometrist is three doors down.
Wonderful.
And he's just great. So I'm glad that I'm here.
No, that's great. Well, is there any other things you would like everybody to know about?
That we're here. We're very home-based. You will get the best clinical perspectives you can possibly think of. Mm-hmm. Okay. I will never let anybody sit here ill without, getting to them the proper care that they need. Because, you know, we get that out of the way so you can live your life and feel good about your life. When you're in pain, you don't feel well, you know. So we get that out of the way, and then we socialize, we engage, we keep you in the community. We keep you at your church. We don't take that away from you, whatever. Mm-hmm. And so we try to humanize that part of elder care.
Right.
Absolutely.
Well, that's amazing. Mm-hmm. I knew, you know, the first time that you came into my office in Zebulon, I could tell that you and your husband were very, very special people.
Well, so, thank you.
And then, you know, coming here and seeing all that you offer just proved that.
Thank you. Well, they put up with me as well because I'm a Gemini and I'm always changing things, like, as I told you, the bedspreads and things of that nature. So they calm me down sometimes. Right. So it's therapy for me as well.
Right. Well, that's wonderful. Now, if there's somebody out there who would like some more information about Gracie Sturtevant, how would they get in touch with you?
Our website, GracieSturtevant.com. And then plus on top of that, I have a lot of brochures and things of that nature. And they can always just stop by.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, let's tell them where we are.
Okay.
Give them the address and the phone number.
Okay. We're on Edinburgh's Keep Drive, 1004, with the second house on the right once you come in the subdivision. Our visiting hours are 10 to 7. Stop by anytime. We love company. We absolutely love company. And we're long-winded, so we love conversations as well. But you can always tour, see if this is a good fit for your relative or yourself if you're coming. And you can always, you know, go on my website, GracieSturtevant.com. My phone numbers are there. I'm very, very available 24/7. I do this stuff 24/7. So you could easily get to see me or my husband or whatever.
Well, wonderful. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much for showing us around today. And, we're happy to have you as a member.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Right. Thank you for your support. Thank you so much.
Okay. The Chamber has some great events coming up. The next one is the Fall Fashion Show with Fashions from Belk. It's a really exciting event. It's our second one. And this year we have an added treat. We're going to have eye fashion from Eye Care Associates. The next one coming up is the Business Expo, which is September 27th. And both of these events are going to be held at East Wake Academy. The Business Expo is just a great place for, you know, the public to come and visit our members and learn about other businesses, and it's also a great business-to-business networking opportunity. It's free to the public. There's samples from local restaurants and giveaways from the businesses, so it's a fun thing to do. You know, you can bring the whole family. And all of the information for all of our events is on the Zebulon Chamber website, which is zebulonchamber.org.